Hey everyone, welcome back to Star Wars Galaxies. With me, Super Vader Man, and our friend Crunch Bar, and his friend, SG567. Not sure why he's named. Maybe he has something important to say. I can converse with him. Oh. Huh. Maybe I have to be on duty. But yeah, I'm on leave right now, so that rebels don't attack me. But yeah, I don't want to be on duty because we're going to a place that is relatively dangerous for people who are on duty. And I failed to mention where that was in the last video. So, where we are going is Yavin 4, the moon of Yavin, the gas giant. Let's go ahead and go to the Imperial Base starport. Alright. We are here in the Imperial Base. See, they're working on a smoking bomber over there. And we have a Lambda shuttle. That's cool. Well, we got some AT-ST wreckage over there, unfortunately. But anyways, this is Yavin. This will be the first of three adventure planets that we'll be visiting. And by adventure planets, I mean you cannot plant a house down here. You can place mineral harvesters here, but you cannot set up a house. Therefore, it is, oh, there goes the shuttle. Is that flying? There's a floating flag up there. Oh, no, it's not there anymore. That was weird. Yeah, this is an adventure planet. You cannot set up cities here. It is relatively uninhabited. There are no one-click cities. There's no cities. There's just little outposts here and there. Apparently only one of them counts as a city. But there are three starports here, so I don't know. But yeah, this is one of those planets where you just kind of go around and explore and find cool things. So let's do that, shall we? Our first stop shall be, well, if I know, points of interest. Let's go to the Great Masasi Temple. But I chose the wrong place to, actually, no. No, let's go to this waypoint here. Because why not? I have another waypoint activated somewhere. Okay. Alright. Since there are no shuttles or anything, I have to get there the, go there the long way, which is by speeder. So there's gonna be a lot of cutting in this video, so, you know, just wanna warn you and apologize ahead of time if that bothers anyone. Yeah, this first waypoint is a little bit ways away, so I'll meet you when I get there. Actually, no, I'll take the time to sort of explain this planet. This is Yavin 4. It's one of the apparently three habitable moons of Yavin, according to the Librarian. And as you can see, it's a very, very jungly planet. Populated by, as I've said, dense jungles and such. Yeah, it's very, extremely lush, even more so than Rory. So, and it's also a very, very dangerous planet. There's lots of aggressive fauna and such here, which are, all relatively high level, like at least 70, I would say. 70s, 80s. And because of that, I leveled up Crunch Bar to level 80. You know, last time he was 65, but I took the time to level him up quite a bit, so I could better explore these planets without being horribly mauled by the local creatures. And we're almost there. Oh, there it is. There it is. It spawned in. And this is one of the somewhat random outcroppings of, I don't know, military occupation. And this is just a base that I found in the middle of nowhere. But last time the entrance was right here, but I guess the base flipped around, I suppose. So now the entrance is up there. That place that we probably shouldn't be able to get to, but I'm going to use some magic teleportation technique right here. Or not. Well, I'm a dirty liar. Anyways, there should be a stairway around the back. Normally when there's an entrance like floating, or it's like under the ground or something, you can just like go there. But apparently that is not the case, because it's too far above the ground. So yeah, I lied when I said that. Yeah, I'm sorry. Luckily there's a second entrance over here. A staircase. There's a tree blocking, damn it. Crap. And there's like a railing that you can't see, it's underneath the ground. So it's that's unfortunate. Both entrances are blocked. Yeah, this is just an unmarked base here. I found it completely by accident. I was just exploring around. I was scouting ahead on Yavin to see, you know, what cool things there were to see. Because I knew that there were unmarked places like this. And I scouted around Yavin trying to find, you know, just cool things to show you guys. And yeah, that's that. That is the inaccessible base, apparently. One entrance is too far above the ground and the other is blocked by a tree. So that's unfortunate. Alright, on to the next site, which would be this mountain. Now we've entered a more mountainous terrain. There is far less vegetation, and what vegetation there is a very, very harsh looking plants that look like they could survive in such a rocky environment. So let's go ahead and, oh god, we're being attacked by something. What am I being attacked by? Oh, it's just some guy who works for the huts. Yeah, the huts don't like me. Yeah, here's, a dormant volcano. Again, just another unmarked thing on the map. That is, pretty cool to go to. It's kind of like the volcano unlock, but with less lava. No, not that it mattered, because the lava didn't hurt you unlock, but whatever. And who are all these guys? Oh, another high expeditionary force guy. What level are you? Yeah, you're level 80. So you're somewhat dangerous. As you can see, there are rebels. Level 80. 84 dudes, so it's a good thing that I went on leave. Yeah, you're just very, very high level guys. And I would be in pretty deep crap if I had not leveled. So yeah. Also being at this level will help me in later videos when I'm go to Kashyyyk and Mustafar, but you know, I'll get to that when I get to that. So on our next stop on Yavin, I guess will be this waypoint up here. Not the Dark Temple, not quite yet. I'll get there when I get there. I'll see you guys when I get to the waypoint. Well, looks like we stumbled upon an open meadow of some kind. With very, very nice looking purple flowers and these cool looking trees. A little bit of different terrain than the rest of the planet. Who are these guys? More hut expeditionary force guys. More rebels. So yeah, I think we're almost there. Yeah, not quite there yet. We're getting a little preview of the upcoming site though, here. This scorched land. Are we almost there, though? Yeah, we're almost there. We're a few hundred meters away. Yeah, if you remember, Yavin 4 was the, was where the Death Star hovered over. And if you notice, you look around this, this place of scorched earth, you'll notice... Well, you'll notice, creatures. What is this? It's like a mule. But anyways, if you look around the scorched earth area, you'll notice bits of debris laying around. That's because that is debris of the former Death Star. You'll see that the trees are all burned and dead. The land is charred and black. And there's all this debris all over the place. And, you know, all these people, all these rebels and such picking through the litter. And there are several places like that throughout the eastern part of this map. All these waypoints are little craters that I've marked that are just full of just charred earth and random debris. And I just thought that was a nice touch that they included the remains of the former Death Star on the planet Yavin 4, well, the moon, anyways. And yeah, larger chunks of debris now. More scorched earth, dead trees. Just very nice attention to detail. And this isn't even marked by a point of interest or anything. This is just found through exploration. You know, that's what I like about these adventure planets. You can just, you know, go around and find cool stuff like this. Find little nods to the movie, to the movies. It's really nice. Got a significantly larger crater here. Yeah, I'm not gonna take the time to show all of these. I'm just, kind of gushing at this point, how much I love these little attentions and details. But yeah, our next stop will be the Dark Jedi Temple. It's over this way. Suppose I will see you there. Alright, so we're almost there. Almost to the Dark Jedi Temple. We're still seeing lots of debris here. Well, I guess it makes sense for, adds to the atmosphere of this, Dark Jedi Temple right here. And we see things similar to what we saw in the one cave on Dantooine. So that's cool, I guess. Makes sense. You know, there was Jedi stuff on Dantooine, and now we're seeing it here again. You know, wherever these Jedi are, oh, that's inviting. Huh. I've actually never been here before. So this is as much of a new experience to me as it likely is to you. Let's go ahead and turn that light point off. Got lit candles here. I'm not sure why they're lit. Unless someone's already here. That'd be unfortunate. Got a lightsaber next to a skull. That's always a good sign. Are these, like, lightsabers belonging to former Jedi, perhaps? That's ominous. Whoa. Whoa. Huh. This is pretty cool. We got these little chairs here. I mean, the chairs aren't cool. I mean, they look cool, but they're not as cool as these giant crystals here. Alright, got the layout right there. It's in this room. Huh. That's a very unfortunate fellow. That's an Ithorian. Ithorian bones. You can tell because of the, that's the skull right there. Huh. What's this say? Rest in peace. Huh. I wouldn't have thought that, that Sith would, put rest in peace on their tombstones. They would probably... I thought they would have put something, like, more sadistic. They're, like, this man killed hundreds of Jedi before death or something. I don't know. What's this say? It's kind of sideways. Wait. Yeah, it's R.I.P. I think you were supposed to read it this way, which is odd. Yeah, that's what it says. It says R.I.P. Basically, rest in peace again. Huh. So I guess this is like also... I guess this is like the... miniature graveyard or something. Oh, wow. Dark Enclave Challenge Terminal? Let's just take a second to look around this room first. It's like a little arena. Like, there's the door where the challenge comes through, and there's the door where the challenger comes through. Wow. This is really cool. What is this about? Dark Enclave Challenge Terminal. Terminal used to challenge for a right to move to a higher rank. Huh. I guess that's what the arena is for. That's cool. Let's go in one of the other entrances. Yeah, like a little meeting hall, little feasting, perhaps. What's that say? It says RIP again. What's this go to? This is just probably goes to the balcony. Yep. You just kind of sit here and, you know, look at the fight as it goes on. Oh, never mind. I guess both challengers come through that door. What is that? Dark Enclave Voting Terminal. You have insufficient rank in order to vote. Huh. I guess you actually have to be like a Dark Jedi to use these terminals. Or maybe you just have to be like... a high enough rank in the Galactic Civil War. Like, right now I'm only a private. Maybe I have to be like a colonel or something in order to vote. I don't know. Whoa. Yikes. Got various refuse down there. Probably belonging to dead things. You know, just judging from the overall theme of this temple. Got scrolls and such. This is probably the feasting hall. It actually has, like, food. Oh, someone tipped over. Got a little drunk on Sith ale, perhaps. It's different from regular ale because it's evil, I guess. Evil booze. Yeah, just more meeting halls and such. Anyways, let's head on to the sort of final area. Yeah, just more halls. Oh, I got like a throne here. Oh, hey. I can actually sit here. I wonder if I can get a chair this size for my house. That'd be cool. I wonder how old this food is. This place has to be ancient. Maybe they just like use really, really, really good preservatives. And it's like still tastes like it's fresh. I don't know. That's cool. Got like a throne there. What's over here? Perhaps a private meditation chamber? Oh, this is like the dark council room. And here's where like the Grand Poobah sits. It's the Sith Moose Lodge. But instead of wearing horns, they just kill people. So yeah, that is the Dark Jedi Temple. It's a very, very intimidating place. Lots of sharp angles and corners to let you know that it's evil. Plus all the hieroglyphs that sport skulls and whatnot. So yeah, where to next? We go to the Temple of Exar-Kun. Sure, why not? Go in like a sort of counterclockwise motion around the map. Yeah, let's go there. I will see you guys when I get there, because it is quite a distance away, and I have to travel by speeder bike. Well, on the way to the Exar-Kun Temple, I had to start crossing this large river of sorts, and I noticed these cute little turtles. He's cute. Oh god, I'm floating. Why am I floating? Ah! I'm swimming in the air. Swim, Crunch Bar! Swim! Swim through the air! Oh god. Why? Let's try calling away our speeder bike. Oh god, no. This is terrible. Well, we can at least see the planet of Yavin. That's cool. Yeah, I saw these cute little polygonal turtles just kind of floating around, doing. Oh, there I go. There I go. Now Crunch Bar is back in the water, where he belongs, because he's a fish. Yeah, these little adorable turtles. But anyways, what is that? Oh, hey. It's a bigger turtle. But it's like, it has a little baby turtle following it. Aw. That's adorable. Sort of. They're swimming under the water. That's cool. Anyways, back to the Exar-Kun Temple. Alright, so we're almost to the Temple of Exar-Kun. I see a... Yep, there it is. The building in the distance. That doesn't look natural. That is the Temple of Exar-Kun. I know that the waypoint points us over to here, but this is the building temple. That over there... Oh wait, never mind. It is pointing us to the building. My bad. Oh god. There's a... possessed rebel troopers in there that are all level 90. Jan Dadana, what are you doing here? You're that guy who told us about the rebel plans in A New Hope. What do you have to say? You do not belong here. I politely suggest that you move on. Oh, okay. You know, since you politely suggest it, who are you? Rolo? Why are you important? Several enforcers over there. Wait, who are you? Luke Skywalker. Hi, Luke. You look kind of derpy in this game, and you have terrible hair. But what do you have to say? I don't think I should be talking to you. Oh. Okay. Bye, Luke. Yeah, Rolo. Why are you important? Why do you have a name? Generally speaking, people with names are more important than those without names. Why are you important? If you don't mind, I'm trying to keep a low profile. Oh. Well, it's kind of hard to keep a low profile when... You stick out like a sore thumb, considering you have the name. Anyways, let's go inside the temple, and hopefully we won't get horribly killed by those possessed rebel troopers. You probably have to come here as like a rebel or something. Yeah. Have to be a member of the Rebel Alliance. So, I'm gonna have to come back with urk'gro'gra'oork. Alright, we are back here with urk'gro'gra'oork at the Exarchun Temple, and with our friend Luke Skywalker. I'm not sure what prompted me to kind of stand creepily over his shoulder like that. But whatever, let's see what he has to say. Have you spoken with General Dodonna? If he doesn't have any orders for you, I think he would know who does. Oh, okay. So let's go talk to General Dodonna. What do you have to say, Jan Dodonna? I do not have any orders for you, Trooper. Have you spoken to Mon Mothma on Dantooine? Okay. So this is part of the, what was that? Champion Sword? It's collectible. Yeah, apparently this is part of the Rebel theme park. Apparently I already have this item in my collection, so whatever. Yeah, we are on Rebel active duty, so let's go inside here. Add the location. Add Exarchun Temple to my collection. Possessed Rebel Trooper. Huh. That's unfortunate. Looks like there's only one in this room, so let's go ahead and take him out. Die, Rebel Trooper. Looks like he isn't that tough, fortunately. Well, until he started throwing like 8 grenades at our face. But whatever. And put that out. Scout jacketed the Janta. That's cool. Sure, I'll take it. Alright. Deeper into the Exarchun Temple we go. Oh, he snared us. Uh-oh. Got another possessed rebel trooper. Can we sneak by you? No? Okay. Probably alerted that other one. Yeah. Pick your poison. Go this way. Go ahead and put a bleed on you. I don't know what I forgot to do. I forgot to, Ah, crap, this guy's gonna get us. Call our medic friend. There we go. That's what he's there for. He's there for emergencies. Heal me, medic. Thank you. Phew. Thanks, medic. Well, apparently this was the wrong direction, unfortunately. Medic's job is never done, urk'gro'gra'oork. So I see. Go ahead and call our junk dealer friend, and get that buff. Done dealing with you, please leave. Okay. Alright, do I have any other buffs that I can use? I can go ahead and use these power-ups. Yeah. Increase my, glancing blow chance. I have, like, armor on that, when I use power-ups, it increases my chance for getting hit with a glancing blow. So yeah, let's go ahead and, take this guy out. They don't seem to do much damage unless they, until they start throwing those grenades. Yeah, it seems that that glancing blow chance really helped me out. Well, all those buffs in general. Got another rebel trooper there, damn. Let's go ahead and wait until our skullduggery is up. We need every little bit of help that we can get. Right, let's go. Die, rebel trooper. Even when I'm a rebel, I'm killing rebels. Who would have thought? Alright. I'm trying to, like, stun him. Then once the stun's gone, I apply the skullduggery to, make the buff last as long as possible. Free shot, yeah. Yeah, now these guys aren't even getting close to killing me. And I have these buffs enabled. Probably be even having an easier time if I got an entertainer buff. But I did not want to bother. At least these guys like aren't in like pairs. Because I know I would not be able to fight these guys two at a time. Smugglers are very good at in one-on-one combat. Not so much in when there's huge groups of enemies. As you will, as you'll see when I get to the Blue Leaf Temple. Go ahead and put the stun on you. Now the skullduggery. I'll just die. You're just like a huge well of hit points to me. You're not even really a challenge. This rebel trooper. Not this place. I mean, this looks cool. I'm failing to comment on the scenery. I'm too focused on combating these guys. Hey, this looks cool. It's like a like ancient techno stuff. It's got like circuitry going into the ancient rock carvings. That's cool. Go ahead and stun you. Got this down to like a science now. This one's a little tougher. Maybe I'm just not being as lucky with my hits. That's probably it. But we're able to keep up with her damage, so nothing to get too worried about. A Kalor Slug Dajaric piece. What's this? That's just garbage. Huh. For some reason there's like a huge hole here in the side of the temple. No idea why. Alright, there's the next rebel trooper. Go ahead and take you out. This room got like this like obsidian looking stone here with all these blue stones, and not really sure what the purpose of this is. Looks kind of cool though. Where do I want to go? Go this way, I suppose. Huh. Got sort of like this altar with this huge red gemstone. I'm guessing it's teeming with dark side energies, considering red is the dark side. Generally speaking. I can't click on anything though, so, you know, whatever. Just looks cool. Where do I go next? Got like this sort of cracked floor room for some reason. Not really sure what the purpose of it is. What is this? A raw force crystal. Huh. Must be for something for Jedi, or maybe for the Rebel theme park. I'm not sure. What's over here? Oh. Purple. Purple is also probably dark side. Hmm. Similar to the other altar. Where do I go? We went into the two side rooms. And the two other rooms there. I see more enemies, though. Is there, like, a upstairs that I need to go to? I don't know. Or maybe that's just people respawning. Hopefully not. Yeah, it's people respawning. I'm just gonna run by these guys. Excuse me, gents. Oh no, I'm being attacked. Oh no. Okay. Yeah, that is the Exarchun Temple. He's got a little statue up there. I'm assuming of himself. I can't really zoom in to get a good look on that. Maybe I'll do something in editing. Yeah, that's the Exarchun Temple. I'll see you back at the tour with Crunch Bar, I guess. See you there. But yeah, also, somewhere around the Temple of Exarchun is another place. What is this? Galactic Civil War Contested Zone? That's not important. There is another place. It is the Exarchun instance. The heroic instance. I'm trying to remember which direction it was. What is this stuff? It's just vegetation. It looked like boxes of some sort. Anyways, there's a heroic instance around here. It is the urk'gro'gra'oork instance, like I might have said, I'm not sure. I'm trying to find out where it is. I don't remember. And in that instance, you fight the ghost of urk'gro'gra'oork or something. I don't remember. Like his spirit or something. I'm trying to find the entrance. I'll get back to you when I find it. Alright, looks like I found it. Is this area right behind the temple, surrounded by level 90 dudes. And this is where the entrance of the temple is. I think this is like a kind of like an excavation site. I can't get too close or else these guys will horribly kill me. And these are urk'gro'gra'oork cultists. I guess this is like an excavation site of some sort, and all these people kind of turned into like mine slaves of urk'gro'gra'oork. So that's unfortunate. I see a guy over here. Hey, guy. Rebel trooper. There's some unusual activity going on. Well, not the supposed dig site. You really think so? There's only a cult. Cultists walking around out in the open. You sure are a sharp one. Yeah, anyways. That's the entrance to the instance. I'll get to showing that eventually when I do the heroic instances. Probably with urk. Alright. Next place. I suppose I'll go kind of along the coast here and go up to this waypoint. I will see you when I get there. So, to save myself some time, I finally had the sense to call up my ship and just... Oops, wrong button. And just fly over the ocean. So I would not be inhibited by the otherwise speed-reducing qualities of the water. They slow down speeders and all that. And one thing that I noticed while flying over the ocean and trying to amuse myself, I can go under the water. Apparently this starship also counts as a submarine. That's cool. We can actually go to the bottom of the ocean. Oh, hey. There's actually, like, seaweed and such down here. Huh. Even though you would normally otherwise never be able to get down here, they took the time to put seaweed underneath the water. That's cool. But anyways. And also that Yavin is huge. And the oven is huge. Can barely fit it on my screen. What is that? It's a hut. It's a cave. Not a cave, what are these people? It's a open the bush. There we go. Go ahead and land and see what this is all about. This isn't what I marked on my map. Apparently it's just short of it. Who are these people? There's people with random names. Apparently they crash landed here on an escape pod. And then they kinda like set up shop here. And have since gone crazy apparently. Luckily they are under level compared to us. So we'll go ahead and put them out of their misery. Oh god, they're Jedi. They're dark apprentices or something. Six. Oh god. Oh god. Go ahead and call our medic friend. Make sure that we don't die. Whew. That was a close one. Yeah, that's an ability I have now. I'm able to call a medic NPC to come help me and heal me. And he's just gonna swim away off in the distance. So yeah, we just, rocket dud. That's cool. Yeah, we just killed some dark Jedi, I suppose. Some Jedi who went crazy here, or something. And we started a collection of some sort. Order 66. Probably under Slayer. Yeah, there we go. Badge and a large amount of XP. That's not much. What is this? Well, apparently those counted as Jedi Masters. So we just killed three Jedi Masters, apparently. Dark Jedi Masters. What's this? Hey. Apparently another collection item. Routini! And keep in mind, I found this completely by accident. This was not marked on the map in any way, shape, or form. And, you know, that's what I love about these adventure planets. You can just find this random crap here. And here's the escape pod they came in on. That's cool. What collection was that for? Probably some housing collection. Housing. Decorations. The potted purple flowers. Oh. I guess that's for crafters. Because normally you can't craft purple flowers, but I guess you can do that if you do this collection. So that's cool, I guess. So anyways, this other waypoint is... we're almost there, so I'll probably just fast forward until we get there. Or until we find something else random and interesting. Hey look, something else random and interesting. Got lots of, smugglers, apparently. What is this place? It's like an engine of some kind. What is that? Bubbling stone? Apparently that's another collection item. Unfortunately, it's covered by all these, hostile elites. I'll probably get horribly murdered if I go in there. Hmm. Is it worth it? Is it worth the bubbling stone? Probably not. No. We're not gonna get ourselves killed over a pretty stone that bubbles. But it has bubbles. You can see the bubbles from here. They're pretty bubbles. I'm gonna risk it, guys. I'm gonna risk it for the bubbles. See if we can let's call our junk dealer friend and get a little bit of buff. A little bit of a buff before we go in. See if I can draw them out one at a time. Or two at a time. Whichever comes first. Yeah, they're bunching up. Yeah, it's raining. Damn it. Hey, dude. Hey, Toskis. Come at me, bro. Come at me. Am I in range? Come on. I know you want to aggro me. I know you do. No? See just how close we can get to these guys. Oh, we can get pretty close to them. You know what? Forget fighting you guys. Oh shoot. If I can just sneak in there and grab this, that would be fantastic. Okay, there's an opening. There's an opening, I'm taking it. My stone. Oh. Damn it. Apparently that's a collection I have to activate. Damn. We couldn't collect the bubbling stone. That's unfortunate. We were so close to it too. But in good news, we are here at this waypoint. It's not really as interesting as bubbling stones. But we do have an old Jedi statue here that I was not aware was here when I marked this location. What's so special about this? Search the statue. Uh-oh. Is this one of those places where you just get randomly attacked by Sith? I'm gonna see. Oh. Apparently this object is not interesting to me. Yeah, we have some ruins here. And it's a preview of what is to come. Because we're going to the Light Temple. There was a Dark Jedi Temple, and now there will be a Light Jedi Temple to show off. And it is really far away, again, unfortunately. So I'll just have to fast forward until I get there. So on my way to the Jedi Temple, I stumbled across this random place. A rebel recruiter. Why are you here? Oh. Well, she doesn't want to talk to us because we're part of the Empire. What's in this bunker? Oh. Apparently we have to be a part of the Rebel Alliance in order to... What are these? Anglers? Oh, those are creepy-ass spiders. Got little mouths down here, and these huge, huge pincers. Oh, they're pretty ugly. But anyways, we will go ahead and mark this location so that we can come back here with our urk'gro'gra'oork. Alright, so we're here at this little rebel bunker that I found. That it would not... Oh, music kicking in there. That it would not let me into unless I was a rebel. So, since urk is a rebel, I'll go ahead and see what's in here. Really? Is that really all that's in here? You made me change characters and such to protect, you know, this secret. This place was a secret. Rebels couldn't get in here. They weren't allowed. That's it. That's all this bunker is for. God damn it. Anyways, that is That's this little worthless bunker. So, I'll see you back at the tour. Alright. We are here. At the Jedi Temple. I'm not sure why I'm looking around. Yeah, you're here. At the Light Jedi Temple Ruins. Already, this is looking more promising than the Dark Jedi Temple. It's nice and clean, for one. Very shiny. Again, I have not ever come here, so this is also a new experience for me. Yeah, this is much nicer. Much more vibrant. Not as grim and moody. It's like kind of a similar layout to the the temple in Knights of the Old Republic. Yeah, sort of, I guess. Maybe, maybe not. Let's go into the central area here. I'll get into the central area. We're in these outer places. Yeah, it's like a little meeting hall. As opposed to the Dark Jedi Temple, which was like all angles and corners and squares and rectangles. This is all curves and circles. To let you know that it's a good guy place. And it uses blues instead of reds. I'm guessing this is just going to be like a similar setup. Yep, just another meeting hall. What about this tiny little room? I guess this is where like the Grand Master sits or something. The Grand Master's chair. He sits here and instructs those beneath him, his Padawans and such. So let's do this, through this chamber. Oh wow. You kinda got like this this Senate sort of setup. Wow, this is cool. Yeah, I guess this is like the Grand Master's sort of seating area. And this would probably be where the Masters sit, and then like Knights and Padawans, and that's cool. I really like the circular setup they have going on here, along with the sort of like stellar motif going on. Very round open chamber. Very cool. Very cool. It's awesome. I'm guessing that they have more of a democratic, like, voting system and such, you know, rather than like a giant pit where you fight to the death, and a huge bone pit, you know, just to kind of show the difference between the two ideologies there, or as opposed to ascending according to martial might. Like in the Sith ways. These are nice chairs. Not really as much interesting stuff going on here. You know, there aren't like grave rooms where they bury their dead and put their skulls over top of their gravestones and such. So yeah. What's in this central? Hey, it's the Light Enclave voting terminal. Insufficient rank in order to vote. I guess you, in case you don't want to like actually be a part of the proceedings, you can just kind of stand up here and check it out. That's cool. That's very cool. Never been here before. Glad I finally got the chance to. And that goes all the way around. So that's the Light Jedi Temple. Very cool. Yeah, our next destination will be... That's just more ruins. You don't need to see that. Do we want to go to the Geo Cave, or do we want to, save that for last? I think I'll save the Geo Cave for last, because that's like... There's something I can do there to sort of end off the video on. Let's go over here. I'm not sure what's over here. All I know is that when I hit the terminal thing, that there's a bunch of terminals over there. Like, Imperial and Rebel terminals. So I'm gonna go see what that's about. What are these? Oh, that's just for the starport up there. Yeah. But yeah, I'll see you, near the center of the map, where that waypoint is. Hey, look, something else random and interesting. It's, another PvP zone. Old PvP. What is this? Oh, shoot. They're all, hostile. Yeah, there they go. I'm gonna run away from them. And then perhaps, when I get out of combat, I will go see them again. There we go. There we go. Alright. Oh, oh. Don't get involved in those guys, either. These guys are even more dangerous. Black Sun. Extremely dangerous. They just look dangerous. Yeah, in the middle of this, this old PvP zone, I just, like, randomly found this, this little get-together of Dark Jedi. See if we can get a closer look without them coming to, horribly murder us. Here you go. Oh, shoot. Okay, luckily it's only two. We can deal with two. Come on, is that all you got? There we go. What is this? I'll go ahead and take that, whatever. Constitution stem. Sure, let's use one. What does it do? Increases our constitution by 40 points. That's cool. How many more are there? There's like six there. See if we can go ahead and pull another couple towards our way. We don't want to deal with them all at once. There we go. Come at me, bro. Get this guy to lead. Looks like the other person's kind of like stuck. There we go. Go ahead and throw a skullduggery on you. Skullduggery being the ability that increases their chance to miss. It's this one right here. Touchy case. That's cool. Carved bowl draft schematic? No thanks. I'm not a crafter. Alright, looks like there's four of them left. See if we can go ahead and pull another two. Come at me. I know you want a piece of this. There we go. Die, Sosteka. You and your other boss in front, too. ID badge. That's cool, I'll take that. Why not? Inventory's getting a little full, though. Hey, look, another potted plant. These Dork Jedi and their potted plants, I tell ya. They really like the garden. Yep, didn't think so. Click Nick. I wasn't expecting you to pop out of the tree there, Click Nick, buddy. Where are you facing? You're just kinda like facing the other way and like farting at me, I guess. Huh. Whatever. Go ahead and collect this potted plant, because why not? Well, I'll tell you why not, because we can't craft flowers. But whatever. You know, it's a nice little it's kinda crooked there. That shelf. Yeah, I tell you, these Dark Jedi, they really love to garden. And who would have thought? Just find a Dark Jedi garden in the middle of this this old PvP zone. Again, just completely unmarked on the map. Completely unmarked. Would have never known it was here if you didn't go exploring. Alright, I'll go ahead and meet you there at the center of the map. Unless we find something else random and interesting once again. Alright, so we are almost there to wherever it is that this place is. Oh, looks like there's a bunker of some kind. You've entered a PvP area, and your service status has been locked to Special Forces. Well, that's unfortunate. I'm kind of scared now. Even though I know there's probably no enemy players here, I'm still kind of scared. Alright, we have an Imperial base here. That's cool. What's in this Imperial base? Probably Imperials. You know, just guessing. Or maybe a sufficient lack of Imperials. Significant lack of Imperials, I mean. I don't know, have like a little entertainment hall here. Or a speech hall or something. I don't know. Imperial control terminal. Access? Can I access this? No, I guess not. Maybe only rebels are allowed in here. I don't know. So, since, what is this? Covert battlefield. This battlefield has an extreme amount of radar jamming, which prevents being seen on local radar screens. Okay. So it means that I can't see enemies on my radar, which means that an enemy player could pop up out of nowhere, and I would be completely unprepared for it. Let's hope that doesn't happen. I mean, who would come to Yavin anyways? We have some ruins over here. This is cool. Yeah, looks like we have rebels in the south, and we have this, this central control place over here. Go ahead and call our speeder. I'm a little bit on edge right now. Even though I know that no one's probably here, you know, it still pays to be cautious. I don't think I've seen this kind of layout before for a building. Yeah, this is interesting. Battlefield terminal. Can I use it? Oh, apparently not. Huh. Well, this is a rather empty building. What use do you have, building? I don't think you have a use. Go ahead and call a speeder. And go more to the south here. Check out these rebel terminals. See if they're See if I'm able to do anything with Rebel terminals as opposed to Imperial ones. Alright, we're in a Rebel bunker now. R2 unit. As you can see, it's, dirtier than the Imperial bunkers. Less kempt, but more homey, apparently. Nice little pictures and such. Repo droids. Droids all over the place. Can I do anything with this? Can I access it? No. Huh. No idea what those terminals are for. Absolutely no clue. Alright, so, we have like a little weapon wall here. That's cool. So yeah, that's the, this is a PvP zone, I guess, on this planet. That's cool. There's nothing here. Can't do anything here. But it's there. Right. Points of interest. Let's go ahead and, tackle these three temples. The Woolamander Palace, the Temple of Blue Leaf, and the Great Masasi Temple. Since we're, quite close by to them. First off, the Woolamander Palace. It is less than a kilometer away. I might just fast forward until I get there. We're leaving a battlefield! That's fine. I don't want to be a part of the battlefield. Am I still Special Forces? Let's go to commands and see. Change duty status. Yeah, we were in Special Forces right there. So we'll be under regular combat status in 5 minutes. Anyways, I think we're almost to the Woolamander Palace anyways. Yeah, just about. As you can see, since I'm changing status, my name is flashing there. I think other people will be able to see that. So we are here at the Woolamander Palace. Very large structure. It has these things called Woolamanders. Which are kind of like these monkey-like creatures with fluffy tails. Brightly colored tails. That's cool, I guess. They're all like level 70 and such. So let's go ahead and enter this place. What are these three pieces of structure over here? These green things. I have no idea. Maybe they're just like these pillars. I don't know. A sickly looking plant? What's special about this? Oh. All these interesting objects just don't interest me. An altar? Please don't tell me this object doesn't interest me. This is a very interesting object. Damn it. What the hell is this used for? I don't know, but it's cool. Let's go ahead and kill some Woolamanders while we're here. While we're in the neighborhood. Unfortunately, they diseased us, so we don't have any action points to spend. Hopefully they don't kill us because of that. That'd be rather unfortunate. And rather embarrassing to be killed by these fluffy-looking monkey things. Luckily that was not the case. And we survived the encounter. Let's actually go inside of the palace instead of, dicking around outside of it. Hey. Got a badge for finding the location. Wasn't that hard considering that there's a point of interest leading directly to it. What is that? Woolamander gatherers. For some reason the gatherers are not hostile. And they have this giant statue dedicated just to them. No idea why Willamanders are important, but apparently they're important enough to dedicate this very, very grungy-looking statue to. Of course, nothing in the Magsteel containers. Ah, damn it. I didn't see you guys. Go ahead and throw a skull debris on you. Before our action gets completely drained by your disease. You have to be careful when spending your action against these guys. Because they have the action disease that really puts a damper on our ability to use special abilities. You know, that coupled on top of the smuggler's naturally high consumption rate of action points. Or Magsteel containers. It's too bad these Magsteel containers are relatively useless. Got some guys in the wall over there. Or past the wall. Let's go check out this this other room. When is this freaking disease gonna go away? Stop it. Go away. Please don't attack me. Damn it. Go ahead and stun you. Bleed on you. Okay, now we're regular combatants, so enemy players cannot attack us. We're still at risk from those relatively high level rebel NPCs, but they're not as dangerous as players. Some more harvesters. Have another large Willamander statue. I wonder if these guys drop any special loot. Probably not. I can loot this guy's heart. That's sadistic. Probably just another Magsteel container over here. Yeah. And another statue. Anyways, that is the Willamander Palace. It's very small, filled with very aggressive monkey things. That's it, I guess. I don't know what kind of people would build this huge temple just for these dumb monkey things. Anyways, on to our next destination, which would be the Temple of the Blue Leaf. I think that has a painting associated with it. I might throw a picture up there just in case it does. Maybe I'll throw up a picture when I get there. Yeah, I'll see you guys there. Alright, we are over here already. So there's the Temple of Blue Leaf. It's a very X-shaped structure, I suppose. I'm not sure what creatures this one is surrounded by. Oh. Clicknicks, apparently. Huh. That's unfortunate. Let's see if we can worm our way through these guys. We got stormtroopers over here. They apparently set up shop right outside the Masasi Temple. Not Masasi. Blue Leaf Temple. Can I talk to anyone here? We got the squad leader. You can tell he's a squad leader because he has darker armor, I guess. So yeah, Blue Leaf Temple. think I'll throw that. Go ahead and throw that picture up here now, if there is one. Yeah, it appears that this place is guarded by all these clicknicks. They're only level 73, so it shouldn't be that tough. But there are three of them, groups of three all over the place. These guys are kind of kicking my ass. Yeah, these guys are gonna kill me. That's unfortunate. At least they don't. At least they don't kill me. They just incapacitate me. That would have been really annoying if they outright killed me and I had to travel all the way back here. Yeah, I guess I'll. I guess I'll just look around the place. I don't think there's anything else to see. Yeah, it's just stormtroopers. We have a white indicator for some reason. I guess all these guys have white shoulder pads. Now, it'd be nice if like I could just like grab five of these guys and charge to the temple. But whatever. Go ahead and just charge in. Hopefully we won't get killed. Kind of thinking we will. But we'll run in as far as we possibly can. We got that badge, that's cool. Run. Huh. These guys are not attacking me for some reason. But I will not complain. Because it allows us to see the inside of this temple. This lovely temple. With a giant crystal in the middle. Is there anything over there? No, it's just two dark warriors. What about these guys? More defenders. I'm kind of wondering if there's a queen down there. Very nice, cool lighting here. Probably provided by the giant blue crystal. You know, just assuming. Yep, clicknick dark queen. Who's free? Go ahead and go and attack the queen. Probably not the brightest idea, but we'll go ahead and do it anyways. Because we're Crunch Bar. Oh god. Oh god. Run. Run, Crunch Bar. Alright, so I guess we're not going to be killing the queen. You get off easy today, Queenie. Yeah, that is the Blue Leaf Temple. Yeah, like these kind of like Aztec-looking symbols on the side. I failed to notice that earlier. Let's go ahead and just wait until our incapacitation timer goes away before we try to charge out of here. How much time do I have? 17 seconds? I'll give it a little bit longer. What to do? Okay, let's go. Let's go! Charge past the clicknicks. Excuse us. Go ahead and, drop a little. Apparently didn't slow him down that much, fortunately. I tried to drop down like a little snare that would keep them from moving as quickly. But I guess they kind of avoided it, unfortunately. But we made it out alive. So that is fortunate. Alright, back to my station. Okay. Whatever. Okay, two temples are down. One temple to go. I'll see you at the Great Masasa Temple. Alright. And now we're here at the Great Masasa Temple. All these places tend to have, well, I mean, all these places have, like, kind of a different design to them. Not sure why that is. But yeah. I think this is, like, one of the temples that the rebels hid inside of. Like, they made it their base. Because it kind of looks similar. Kind of. Hopefully there won't be any rebels here, because I am, on active duty. Looks like we have an Imperial encampment out front here, so that's fortunate. Huh. There we go. There's more enforcers. Yeah, we have an entrance over here. Let's go inside there and see what that's all about. See what it looks like on the inside. If I'm not mistaken, the Masasi were like a tribe of ancient people. But then some dudes landed here, and like some humans, some Sith, and you know, the two got mixed up, like genetic wise, because they bred together or something. And you know, stuff went down, I guess. What did I hear? Oh, that's a door. Oh, okay. Looks like this is an Imperial place. Belongs to the Imperials. Lieutenant Commander Ginz Daron. As part of the Empire salvage operation on Yavin 4, I'm hunting the rebels and their secret weapon. Our probes just sighted a rebel squad that apparently got stranded in the jungle. They may have been retrieving the weapon from a hidden cache. I want you to assemble a team, hit them hard, and take the weapon. No thanks. I'm doing a tour here, buddy. I can't do your work right now. Yeah, I think there was a door over here. I kind of mistook it for a wall. Like these places. These doors. Is this a... Oh. Well, I guess it might as well be a wall. It doesn't open. Alright, let's see what's deeper down, or further up, I suppose. Either way, it's deeper into the temple. I was gonna say, what is the purpose of this room? Oh, hey. Yeah, this is like, I think this is, like, one of the temples, like, you see... I remember a place just like this in Jedi Outcast. This is where Luke set up his little Jedi Academy in one of these Masasi temples. I don't know if it was this one in particular or not, but it was definitely a temple with this sort of layout. I just don't like the climate here. I plan to be off this world as soon as I finish the salvage operation and learn what I can from that abandoned rebel base. Speaking of which, I need someone to pick up a report from the forensics team. I can't do that, mister. Yeah, that is the upper floors of this place. I think there was a hallway leading to deeper floors. I'll have to go see about that. Yeah, the Masasi. I know that they were an ancient tribe of people of some sort, but I don't know... I'm not sure if they were the ones who interbred with the Sith, or if it was another species. I don't know, the Masasi sound familiar like that. Again, I'm not... Here's the hangar bay. Hangar bay like the rebels would use. Very bare. Why aren't you guys using this place? You just want to send me off on another menial task? Yeah, you do. It's a shame that they don't ever, like, use this. They could, like, fill us up with, like, all sorts of cool stuff, but all they do is put this lone dude here, who gives you a quest and sends you off to a very less interesting to look at place. That's unfortunate. Yeah, they just have all these great art assets to this game, like all these cool places, but they just don't use them. It's very unfortunate. So yeah, it's a great Masasi temple. I wish I could tell you more about the Masasi, but I'm not familiar. Again, I'm just not familiar with Jedi and Sith lore. I'm much more interested in like the technical aspects, like during that quiz on Naboo, I was able to just, you know, right away know like things about those, like what those ships were called, things about them. But the Jedi stuff, yeah, I just didn't know anything about that. And I think this down here is just like this place, just another PvP area. So I'm not gonna bother with that. So I guess we'll go to our last stop, the Geonosian Cave. And we'll see you there. So on the way to the Geo Cave, I found something else random and interesting. Found a gathering of people here around this little encampment. And what is that? That's just a large potted plant. So I don't think I'm gonna bother with that. That's a cactus this time. Apparently smugglers are more interested in cacti. And Sith are more interested in purple flowers. The more you know. Yeah, I'm not gonna bother with that. I'm not a crafter. So I cannot craft the schematics that those collections would give me. Yeah, back to the Geo Cave. Alright, so I'm almost to the Geo Cave. I spotted something, again, random and interesting, on my way to the Geo Cave, and it looks like it's some ruins. I wonder if there's gonna be hostile creatures here. Oh, well, there's creatures here. Tank mites. Huh. Is there anything on this? Little bit of ruins? Or is this just kinda here? Yeah, it's just kinda here. But anyways. The Geo Caves are relatively close. They are... Oh, there we go. It's only 300 meters away. And I can see it on my map. That's cool. We won't enter the Geo Caves just yet. There's something else that I wanted to do before entering. And that is... fight that thing. The Mutant Acklay. Oh, got some quick nicks. Watch out. Looks very intimidating, even from this distance. Go and throw away our speeder bike. Let's try and get a good view of this guy. Not covered by ferns and whatnot. There we go. That is the Mutant Acklay. Apparently some sort of, bioengineering project by the Geonosians. And it's different from a regular Acklay. As you can see, it has all sorts of spines all across its body, down its neck, down its back, on all its ridges, on its legs even. It has kind of like spikes on the side of its head. And it even has like a second carapace. Like a second, I don't know, frill coming out from under its first frill. So yeah, that's interesting. And we are going to fight it. We are equal level to it, and it is an elite. Hopefully this goes better than that one-on-one fight we had on Locke, where it was kind of a tie. So I'll go ahead and... plus I have a number of abilities to help myself with. You can go away, just give me my buff. Let's go ahead and use that constitution thing we got. Why not? Alright. Let's do this. Going down, Akle. Going down. Brah! Bleed. Let's go ahead and call our medic friend. Just to be sure. Oh, this is going a lot better than that fight unlock. Alright, heal me up, medic. Heal me up. There we go. Thanks, dude. Alright. Thanks, medic. Make sure you take plenty of fluids next time, Crunch Bar. Sure thing, dude. And yeah. I think it was a helmet. It's kind of crappy, though. No thanks. I will take the hunting trophy of Mutant Akle, though. Go ahead and get a closer look at that. I killed this earlier, just to make sure that I could, because I didn't want to come all this way and then just die. So I have two hunting trophies. I also have the badge for killing a trophy creature. And yeah, that is our hunting trophy of the Mutant Akle. That's cool. We were able to take someone of our own level and of elite status, so go me. Beat the crap out of them. Unfortunately, we will not be so capable at taking on the Geo Cave. I can find the entrance. I see this blue line here, so I'm guessing it's over here. Where's that damn entrance? Okay, I'm almost there. Here's the entrance. Go and enter here. And unfortunately, I will not be able to show you this for a while. Not even with urk, because just at the entrance of the cave, there are level 90 Geonosians. A whole elite status. As a Geonosian, he's got like all these ceremonial wraps and such. And a sonic pistol. Crazed Geonosian Guard. And there are like four of them right there. Right at the entrance. So, we have no chance in hell of even getting past the entrance to go deeper into the cave. So that's unfortunate. There's a scientist here though. What do you have to say? What? Why, you're here? Did they send you? I see that you're here.
Did who send me? What's going on here?
Help! Help! Are you here?
Yes, I'm here. Now what's going on?
Yes. Yes, you are. I see you. Now you must go.
Go? Go where? Tell me what's happening.
What isn't happening? You, that's what.
Why? Go now. Oh, okay. I'm going.
Yes, yes. Keep going. That way. No, wait. That way.
Okay. Apparently this person has completely lost her marbles. And I'm not sure why that is. Probably the same thing that turned these Geonosians into crazy Geonosians. You know, I'm just going to assume. What is that up there? And some kind of implementation. Yeah, this Geocave was implemented as part of the Rage of the Wookiees thing when they added Kashyyyk in. And it's fairly important to crafters, because you can get, like, Geonosian Power Cubes here, which are used for something. I don't know. I've never crafted anything that used them. So yeah, when I eventually get to Kashyyyk, which should be relatively soon, and when I get to doing the quests that involve this cave, I'll probably get a group together and go down here and show you. But as for now, I'm going to end off the tour right here. Security system of the facility has been cycled and reset. And yeah, if you leave the cave,
It resets all the systems. It's not like the Warren where it resets them after a set period of time. You actually have to leave for it to happen. But yeah. We'll end off here. End off in front of the Geo Cave. And, yeah. Killed the Aklay, so that's a good enough part to leave off on. And that is Yavin 4. Next video, I will be touring the planet of Endor. Or the moon planet, Endor. I don't know. And it started raining. Anyways, this has been Super Vader Man. Thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.